Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Here are some tips for dealing with Safari browser tabs on your iPhone. So when using Safari on your iPhone to browse the web, you're probably using tabs, whether you realize it or not. So here I am in Safari, and I'm just viewing a web page. And this web page is being viewed in a tab. You don't really have windows in iOS, so every page that you're viewing at the same time is basically in a new tab, like it would be in a single window on a Mac or PC. You can see all of your tabs by using this button at the bottom right that looks like two squares. If you don't see the controls here, it's probably because you're in the middle of the page. Scroll down a bit and these controls should appear, and then you could tap here and see all of your tabs. I've got two tabs open here, but chances are you've got more, and you can scroll through them. And then to jump to any tab, just tap it and you'll go to that tab. Tap here again, and then you can choose another tab. So how do you open new tabs? Well, a lot of times when you tap on a link, it automatically opens a new tab if that's how the website is designed. However, you can force it by tapping and holding a link like this. You get a little preview there, and you'll get a context menu at the bottom that includes open in a new tab. So now I've created a new tab, and you can see here, I now have three tabs open. You can also tap and drag a link like this, and then with another finger, tap on the tab overview button at the bottom right. And now you can drop this into a position here to create a new tab with that link. You can also create a new tab with just your start page or your browser's home page showing by tapping the tabs button at the bottom right, and then tapping the plus button on the left, and now it'll create a new tab with your start page there. So you can see now I have four tabs. Now, if you're like most people, you probably have way too many tabs open, and some of those are for pages you haven't viewed in days. You can close any tab using this interface here by simply tapping the X button right there. So I'll close this tab like that. Now, if you want to clear this all out and close a lot of tabs, you can do it by tapping and holding that X button at the top right, and you get some options. One of them is just close that tab, but you could also close all other tabs, leaving that tab as the only one that's still open. But you can also do this without even going to the tabs overview. You can just tap and hold here at the tabs icon at the bottom right, and you see I've got the ability to close this tab or close all of the tabs, clearing them out. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. Now, if you've closed a tab by mistake or just want to get back to one that you had open earlier in the day or something, you can go to the tab overview. And with the plus button here, you can tap and hold, and you're going to get a list of recently closed tabs. So you can open up one of those tabs again very easily. Now, you can get to another tab by tapping the Tabs button and going to Tabs Overview, but you can also use the bar here at the bottom. If you tap and swipe over like that, you can go between all of your tabs very easily. If you don't see it like that, you can go to Settings and then go down to the bottom of the list and you'll see Apps. Tap there and then go to the S's and then Safari. And in Safari, you've got some settings here. Scroll down. You've got settings for tabs, so you can have the tab bar at the bottom, or you could just have a single tab showing at the top. So if you want to be able to swipe between them, make sure you've got tab bar on here. You can also decide whether or not there's the tab bar there in landscape mode. And when clicking on links that go to a new tab, you can jump to the new tab or have that tab open as another tab, but you don't go there right away. Now, there's also a very important setting here if you find you accumulate a lot of tabs. Right here, you've got closed tabs. You can have it on manual where you have to close all the tabs yourself, but you can also have tabs automatically close after 1 day, 1 week, or 1 month. Use one of these if you find you accumulate dozens or even hundreds of tabs. When you go to the tab overview screen, you can not only select a new tab, but you can rearrange these. So if you want to drag this first tab down, you can, and put it as the last tab in the list. You also can swipe down here and note that you can search tabs. So you can just limit what you see to certain keywords. That's particularly useful if you've got lots of tabs open. You don't necessarily want to close any of them now, but you know that the information you want is on some tab in that list. You can just search the pages that you've got open. Now, you also have the ability to have tab groups. Notice here, I've got a single tab group, the default one, and it just shows the number of tabs I've got open, 3 tabs. But I can tap here, and I can create a new tab group, and then I can name it, and now I've got a second tab group. I can swipe between these here. So in this tab group here, I can open up a bunch of tabs. Maybe it's, say, for vacation planning or research for work. And then I can go back to this tab group here where I've got my other pages open. You can add a whole bunch of different tab groups open and these sync with iCloud. So you'll see the same tab groups on your other Apple devices as well. If you do have tab groups, you can move pages between them. If you tap and hold on one of these, you'll see you can move tab and select another tab group. You can also choose to pin a tab. You can choose that in the context menu here. And you can see it appear now at the top. It'll stay there in this tab group here, always at the top and easy to get to. This also makes it harder to accidentally close this tab. A tab group that's always going to be here to the left is the private group. So these are private windows here. In other words, they don't share the cookies and website data with your other browser tabs. So if you're logged into a website with an account, you can use private browsing to see what the website looks like if you're not logged in, or perhaps logged in using a second account. It'll treat the private browsing tab like you're a different person on a different device. Another useful thing you can do when you've got tab groups is when you tap and hold a link, you can not only open it in a new tab, but you can choose specifically which tab group to open it in. Drag and drop also works with In Tab Overview. You can tap and drag one of these, and with another finger, tap one of the other groups at the bottom, like that, and now you can drop this tab into this group. You can do it with multiple tabs as well. You can tap and hold, and then select tabs. Now you can tap to select multiple tabs. Now with multiple tabs selected, you can use the move button here to move them. You can close them. You can tap this button here and do even more things, like copy multiple links at the same time to paste them into a document, say. You can also tap and hold to bring most of this up in a context menu, or you can tap and drag multiple tabs into another tab group. So I hope this helps you level up your Safari tab skills on the iPhone. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.